Hello. Good afternoon. I hope that everyone can hear us. If there's any problem with the sound, please let us know in the question part of the GoToWebinar. My name is Mihai Predescu, and I'm a Romanian engineer working in Romania mostly. I've graduated in 1995, and since then I've been working for Romanian companies and two American companies, which one is Parsons and the second one is FEM. I've been working with MIDAS from 1993. When I had the first experience with it, working for a project in Doha with ECO. During my activity, I have designed, let's say, different kind of bridges, like simply supported continuous beams, continuous composite bridges, cable stayed bridges, not with very big spans, but still this is the statical scheme, and arches. The scope of today's presentation is to show you, let's say, a small bridge, not a very big one, located in the western part of our country, in the city of Oradea. It's crossing a river which is called Crișul Repede, and the main span is around 73 meters, as you can see on the screen. Is not, let's say, our country is quite a seismic area, but not exactly in this part. As you can see on the screen, the location of the seismic area in where this bridge is located is characterized by a ground acceleration of 0.15 g and a corner period of 0.7. Initially, during the feasibility study, the scheme of the bridge was something like you see in the picture, and it was not possible to change it too much because it was based on an architectural design. The bridge was opened in the 1918 on 1st of December in order to mark 100 years from our unification of our main provinces. The shape of the stays you can see here are a little bit inclined in order to look like kind of a crown. The bridge will carry two lanes for the cars and two footways of 3 meter each, located at the exterior of the main arches. And the center distance between the deck and the arch is 6 meters. It's not very high because actually the architect didn't want it to be very very high, because the houses which are nearby are also not very high, and they didn't want the bridge to be something not in the view. The substructure of the bridge is composed of two abutments you can see there, which are staying on drill piles with diameter of 1.5 meters. You can see here the cross-section of the bridge, the distance, center to center distance between the main arches are 10 meters. And we have the deck is composed of two main boxes, these two located at around around 10 meters or so. And then we have an arch which is varying in shape for the lateral stability. You see that the arch is, the width is lower at the base, and at the center is a little bit wider. As I told you, we have a 7.8 carriage weight for two lanes of cars. The normal lane is 3.5 meters, so we have another 40 centimeters for the curb effect. The footway is realized on some cantilevers, which are placed at around 2.5 meters approximately. And we have an orthotopic plate, which is resting on this cantilever. The bridge was modeled in MIDAS civil, and here is the initial model. The elements, I mean the deck, the arches are modeled with beam elements. We have then the cross beams, which are also beam elements, but the kind of section is different. And then we have the stays, which are modeled with truss elements, although here it was not really necessary to make it with truss, but we did like this because actually the stays are more or less almost vertical, so it's not a big influence on the stiffness. And the abutment itself is made with the 3D elements. Now, as any bridge, actually, it is important to take into consideration the way the structure is actually built. So, what we had actually on site is based on the left drawing, in which after the discussion with the manufacturer, we decided to have some, let's say, connection points at the deck and some connection points at the arch as well. Now the points are not the same. The points are actually decided by the possibilities of transportation, because actually the factory which was doing the steel works was based in the south part of the country, somewhere in Pitești, and the distance between the fabrication site and the construction site is around 600 kilometers, so it's a problem of transportation as well. We decided to have these points of connection between the, let's say, prefabricated elements. We had this element made entirely on site, this and this. And after that, the deck elements, which are located between these two temporary supports. And then we have the arch, which has only two points actually has three, one is also here. So we have a connection here, and a connection here. Now, in order to model this thing into MIDAS civil, we used temporary supports on the model. And actually, in order to model the fact that we don't have bending moments here till the connection is made, we had here some beam releases applied on the beams. The beam releases are actually how we did it. We go to boundary. And from this point, we choose release offset and beam end release, as we can see it here. We had releases on both directions for the bending moments. The second stage of construction for the bridge was with the structure still on the temporary support. We had the loading of the on the fresh concrete of the deck. The concrete is only connected to the cross beams and not to the beams itself, and the reason is that for this kind of bridge, the deck is actually made mainly the main let's say force which is acting on it is the axial force, which is tension. So we don't want the slab to be tensioned. It will not behave well. We had some bridges in Romania constructed in this way, with connections between the main beams to the slab, and there were a lot of cracks in the slab. And in some cases, because of this phenomenon, the designers chose to make post-tensioned slabs, and even those didn't react very well. So we decided to not have any connection between the slab and the main beams, and all the slab is only connected to the cross beams. As I told you initially, the cross section which we used for the chrome series for this reason was a composite section in which the steel part of the cross beam and the slab are activated at different times. After this, the next phase is to activate the stays. The stays are not, let's say, tensioned separately, like in the case of the cable state bridge, because of the inclination, which is not very big. So we just install it, tension a little bit each of them to be in some kind of force inside. And after that, we just release the towers. So you can see here, we had a removal from the intermediate supports and temporary hinges. And after that, the structure remained like in the final position. Now, what you see here is, you see that we still have here this element, because this is the final model. But in the initial model, which we have made, these releases here were not, because the structure was fully connected to the arch with the abutment. But the thing is that we will come back to this a little bit later. Also, there are, time-dependent material which effects which we have to consider in the slab. So for this, we have used the clip and shrinkage and compressive strength options from MIDAS. We can find it in properties, and then clip shrinkage or compressive strength options, and then we can choose whatever parameters we think are suitable for it. So coming a little bit back, as I told you initially, the structure was fully connected to the abutment, the arch. The deck itself is resting on some pot bearings, which are not very high. The reactions are not very high. Those are not very important. But the connection, that connection between the arches and the abutments gave us a lot of headaches, actually. Because after running the first seismic analyze, we saw that the first period of the bridge was 0.709, which is actually very close to that of the ground. So if those are very close, there is a very high risk for resonance. Even that area is not, let's say, a very high seismic area for this country. But still, we couldn't leave the bridge in this way. So, in order to do something, we couldn't change the design, because it was already approved by the client, which was the Oradea City Hall, and we had to find the solutions to minimize the influence of the earthquake in the behavior of the bridge. So what we did, we tried to release the bridge actually in the transversal direction during the seismic events. But in the same time, during the normal service, the bridge should be kept fixed. So to achieve this behavior, we were, let's say, collaborating with Flesinet through our Romanian branch, which is called Flero. And we placed a PDS damper at each side of the bridge, and the structure is now connected through the PDS. I mean, the arches are connected through the PDS to the abutment, and we released, you'll see later in some picture, we released the displacement of the bridge in the transversal direction. MIDAS Civil offers the possibility to model this through three kinds of behavior of these dampers. One is the Maxwell model, the Kelvin model, and the combined Maxwell-Kelvin model. We used the Kelvin model, and you can see here the parameters which he used. We talked quite a lot with the designers in Italy, which were the suppliers of these dampers, and we achieved these parameters in order to increase the vibration period. You can see here how the dampers were placed in the middle of the bridge. So we have one here and one here. And this is the only thing that we have done in order to change a little bit the behavior of the bridge. Running again, you can see that the behavior is increased quite a lot, let's say. From 0.7, we still have that 0.7, but now the fundamental period of the bridge is now 2.82. So I think it's a lot better than previously. You can see here how actually we have done this, because actually the damper is somehow in this area. It's not a very good picture, but anyhow, the damper is somehow here. And the arches are not now connected to the abutment. They are actually capable of moving in the transversal direction. They are having a Teflon plate at the bottom, but still the bending moments of these arches are restrained to these kind of elements which we put at the abutment. So they cannot rotate actually, but they can translate, and they cannot they can only transfer compression forces through the abutment, but there is no way we can have here tension forces. For this element, for these connections here, we, let's say, analyzed different models. One kind. This is, I think, from the first kind, but we had some quite big stresses in it. And after that, this is the final one, which you can see here exactly how it was designed. Another let's say thing that is important for this kind of bridges is the buckling analysis. The buckling analysis actually can be done very easily in MIDAS, but we have to do a different model, because it's not possible to run simultaneously models which are having settlement time history, response spectrum, moving load analysis, and so on. So we just create another one, and then we have to go to analysis and then choose buckling. And from buckling, we chose 10 modes of buckling, and positive value only, but anyhow, to not make a difference. And now MIDAS is considering, two kinds of loads in order to analyze the bubbling. One is the constant kind of load, which are the dead load and the superimposed dead load, which are constant tensions. And then, as we cannot use the moving loads into this kind of analysis, we just consider as variable the weight of the concrete on the bridge. So this was risk considered as variable. After running the analysis, you can find the bottom mode shades, and you can find the eigenvalues here, which are actually the critical load factors for the variable load. So we can say that the variable load should be multiplied by these eigenvalues in order to get a buckling. So in this case, it means that the load which is applied on the structure should through the concrete slab should be multiplied by 5 in order to get a buckling, which is obviously not the case. The bridge was finalized just a few days before 1st of December 2018, and was actually open for traffic exactly on 1st of December. It was a pretty nice opening. You can see it here, and actually now it's kind of a mark for the city. People are crossing the bridge, making pictures and things like this. And there are also some people which are working with the bicycle on the bridge, although it's not allowed, but I mean on the arch. Now I think this kind of amusement was blocked now at the end of the bridge, but at the beginning it was possible. Now we finished a little bit earlier than it was we thought, but maybe if we have questions we can elaborate a little bit on the project. Okay, one second. We have some questions. I'll take it hopefully one by one. So the first one is, any particular reason for not providing braces at top connecting the arches? The arches, actually, as I told you from the beginning, the arches, the connection between the distance from the deck to the arch is only 6 meters, and we have to assure a 5.5 meters for the cars, for the trucks. So it was not possible to have the connections at the top. Okay, because otherwise it will hit the. The connection between the arches. Okay, I'll try to open the file to take a little bit, but we'll open it. Okay, until the the model is opening. I'll try to take some other questions. 1 second. Okay. If there is a question how clip and shrinkage affect the structure, not very much. The thing is that the clip and shrinkage will affect actually only the cross beams, because the effect on the concrete is only on the cross beams. We didn't have. There is another question in the bucking analysis that might take account of the pretension force. I think it has. I'm not sure fully, but here is not the case actually, because actually we don't have any pretension in the space. The forces were quite small when we released the temporary supports. What was the reason behind utilizing 3D elements on the bottom? Actually, we wanted to see what will happen. It's it's a massive element. We could have done it through a very stiff beam element, but we wanted to see what will happen on the piles as well. How will transmit exactly the forces to the piles? Okay, why the structure form were decided to adopt cable arch bridge rather than another structural form? As I told you, there was a feasibility study made previously, and this was the shape which was liked by the Oradea City Hall. It's not something that we could have changed. Of course, it's not a big span. Some other, more economical structures could have been done, but this was the will of the client. So, is there an example going different in the operation now? There is a question here. I don't really understand. Maybe I can elaborate a little bit. Is there any maintenance considerations in developing the unique compression arc supported abutment? This really, I'm sorry, I don't understand. How long did it take to model this bridge in MIDAS? Actually, not very long. There are, of course, it didn't take very much, but the thing is, you have to change it from time to time. You cannot do it from, at least I was not capable to have the best results from the first trial. And then during the design, the client wanted, because initially the stays were fully vertical. They had an idea to change it, to make it like some kind of race in order to model that ground. The model itself, I think it takes a few days, more or less, if not 2-3 days, if not more than that. But then, of course, when you first run it and you see that the period of the bridge is not exactly very nice, you have to think how kind of device to use, and then we have to discuss with the suppliers what they can do, because not all the time they can do what we want. What happens if you don't do construction stage analysis? Well, I think it's not entirely correct if you don't do it. We actually do construction stage analysis for any kind of bridge, because we want to reflect in the model exactly what is happening during the day zero. If you don't do like this, for example, the arch or the deck, if you consider from the first time, you'll have the dead load of the bridge between two stays, which is around, I don't know, 2 meters or something, 5 meters. I don't know exactly how much is the distance, but we can see here. So the distance between is 4.95, so around 5 meters. So you have the bending here, like let's say like some kind of continuous beams on elastic supports, which was not the case initially, because initially we had only some temporary supports at a much bigger distance. And also the same thing for Dutch. So it's better to all the time consider, in my opinion, construction stages, because it's giving you the right stresses in the model. What is the radius of curvature of Dutch? Is not, it was the same thing I told you before, is not up to us. It was not up to us, it was up to the architect, which was imaginated this thing. So we just had one drawing, and they said, okay, you have this drawing, you designed the arch, something like this. Can you break down? Yes. Yes. What is the positive value in buckling analysis? Sometimes you are getting, I'm not exactly sure, I didn't, but sometimes you are getting, as you can see in the file. No, second. As you can see in the file, in our case, it's always positive, right? But sometimes you are getting, I'm not sure, it's a mathematical model. In my case, in my opinion, if you are getting something negative, it's somehow strange. It means that it's already, I don't know, maybe it's already buckling or something, because normally it should be positive. Okay, related to the temp. Okay, let's go back to the model. You'll see here the damper. We can visualize the damper through boundary general link. So you can see that the link is somewhere here. There are some notes, but I'm not sure how clear it will be if I activate the notes because of the 3D elements. Because if I activate those, it will take a little time. Related to the temples, will this change the inspection of maintenance regime of the structure? Yes, of course. I mean, we had to give the client a manual of inspection. They had to have a look at the dampers each, I don't know, after a special event maybe, or one time per year to see if something happened. Maybe it's not in the right position or so. But hopefully they will do it, because in Romania, not all the time. City halls are inspecting their structures, but hopefully they will do it, and if necessary they will change it, or I don't know, put some oil inside or something. The connection between the cross beams and the tie beam. I don't know what the tie beam. Maybe the deck. The deck is fixed. The deck is fixed because actually the connection between the cross beam, the steel beam, and the deck itself is welded. Only that the slab is not connected in any way directly to the deck. The model we can provide, yes, no problem with the model. How did you found it? Okay, there was not such a big area, a big thing. They make some, let's say, temporary. If you want, I can try to to show you some pictures if I have, maybe. No, 1 second to look after them. I think we have something from the exhibition, but generally they are just making a small foundation, concrete foundation in the, they are deviating a little bit the river, making a small foundation, and after that installing the temporary towers. Those, the reactions are not very big, and the water itself is not very, they can divert the water a little bit till, but I'll show you, let me find the pictures maybe. 1 second. I think the pictures are on my Google Drive, so I have to search a little bit for them, but no problem. Okay, so you can see here some pictures from another project. Okay, this is the project we are talking about, and actually I think you can see it here, you can see the towers. Now these are the towers here, you can see the foundations here. And this is actually after the bridge was, let's say, completed more or less, and they were removing the towers. But you can see the foundations here, the river, which was deviated a little bit. They just left a small part from where the river can flow, and they have these towers here and here. Is this picture is actually from the dismantling of the towers, but more or less you can see it there. Okay, the parameters for modeling the soil, were considered from the, let's say, geotechnical study. And we had some springs at the model. 1 second. Now it's taking a little bit long to generate because of the. The stakes are in different angles from the vertical. There, yes, it is obviously because there is a little bit of inclination, but it's not significant. I mean, compression is not significant due to the stake. You can see it here. So the piles are actually, they are having spring supports on their length. There is a question, is it a standard form of a damper used in this project? Or is project specific? Actually, it is general. Those dampers are project specific. They are not actually, let's say, typical. They are designed as per the, let's say, designer requirements and factory possibilities. It's actually what I did until now in all the cases. It was actually some kind of collaboration between the bridge designer and the supplier of the isolator, actually meaning LRBs or HDRBs or dampers or even connectors. So you cannot take it from one, let's say, prospect of one company and put it into your design. There are suppliers which are providing this kind of brochures, but mostly they are only indicative. Generally, when you have some parameters, you have to send that to them, and then they will come back with some, let's say, they will say, okay, we can do exactly this, which is didn't happen up till now, or we can provide you these parameters, can you put into your model to see if it's acting well or not. And it's some kind of collaborating until you reach, let's say, an agreement. There is actually one thing with the dampers and with isolators in general. They have to be tested, and they have to be tested at a scale of 1 to 1. And there are not so many, let's say, laboratories which can do this kind of work. Actually, there are a few in the world, I think. And one of it, I think, is in Italy. There is one very big one in San Diego. I think it's the biggest one. And there are some others as well. But actually, I'm not sure how is in some other parts of the world. I suppose it's the same like here. Here, the client, they want it yesterday. If you can deliver the project yesterday, it's very good. If you are asking the supplier of the damper something, let's say, unique, they have to test it. And they will have to go to this laboratory to test it. And these laboratories that also have a schedule, and they can say, okay, we'll test the device, but after 5 months or so. So you lose 5 months just to have, let's say, something like, okay, the device is good, then you can proceed with it. So the client will not accept that. So this is why sometimes these suppliers have from different projects, different kind of designs which are tested actually. So they are providing you with something which was already tested, and it goes a little bit quicker. Unfortunately, I was looking on my files for these photographs of the damper, but I didn't see it. But what I can promise you is that tomorrow I have to go to Rada for another research and another work. But I'll go to this bridge as well, and I'll make some pictures, and I will discuss with MIDAS to upload it somewhere. I'll make a picture exactly at the location of the damper. Okay, related to the damper properties, you can see it here in the boundary. Okay, we have to switch to design. Okay, so the properties of the damper, you can see here. We also made some, so actually what is really important for the damper is the nonlinear properties, which are, these are the, let's say, parameters which we have discussed with the supplier. You can see actually the equation which is based for the behavior of the damper itself. So actually what is really important is the damper stiffness and the reference damping force. This is all because actually the reference velocity is just something to, you can see here that you have this sign. Let's say mostly this is 1, and the damping exponent is generally 0.1 in all the time. We can give you some other properties from the discussions with the suppliers as well. That is not a problem. The size of main arch, you can see it on the webinar as well at the beginning. Okay, yeah. So it's starting from okay, here. Well, I'll show. Okay, anyhow, at the top is 1.6 by 0.9, and at the beginning, let's say, you can see it here, is mostly like a rectangular shape, like the deck itself. You see, this part was casted, let's say, in just one part. I mean, it was some kind of difficulty here, even for the guys which were built this cross section, because this intersection is not easy to do. But they managed. Although they have they had to do some modification in the factory as well because of this, because of the height of from here to here, from this point to this point. So they had to do some modifications in the factory, but finally they did it. It is kind of complicated detail here. It's not so much space. It was difficult for the welders as well, but they managed. Actually, it was a woman who made the weldings inside because she was smaller, and she was very good at what she was doing. So the frame model, okay. And this actually there are 90,000 3D elements here for this abutment, which is like one of you already said it, maybe what was not necessary to put all these 3D elements here, but this is how we did it. One second, I am to finish. I just want to take out the joints. Now, there is a question: did you create a model through a wizard in MIDAS, or did you draw the line art tool? No, the model was created in CAD and after that imported. I'm not aware to have a wizard for this kind of structure, at least not for Dutch. Anyhow, you can see here a little bit how the damper is placed, and it is connected to one of the cross wheels and the abutment. It's kind of difficult to show because it's not very fast, the rendering. What is the maximum magnitude of the earthquake this bridge is designed for? Actually, in Romania, we have, I'll show you exactly how it is in Romania. Okay, so we have this map here. So actually the city of Oradea, one second. Okay, so let's say high seismic area is this part. We are calling it Vrancha. And Bucharest is where I am located, is here. Vrancha area is here. And the city of Oradea is here. Okay, so it's not something you can see here, 0.15 G. But the maximum earthquake is around 8 degrees. But it's 8 degrees, obviously 8 degrees in this area, it does not have, I mean, it's a completely different thing in Oradea. So it's not, let's say, this area, it's quite okay from the seismic point of view. The only thing is that the structure is kind of stiff. And if we are looking at the other parameter, which is the corner period, I'll show you exactly, because we have this as well. And this is the map for the, why am I not loading? Okay, so this is other map which is showing the corner period. So the corner period here for most of the country is 0.7. So although you don't have a very high acceleration, but you have a small corner period. In Bucharest, for example, is 1.6, is the maximum one. This is 1.6, and then we have one, and then we have 0.7. But this 0.7 is not very good for different structures. Regarding the temperatures, I told you I will send you more information to MIDAS, to the photographs as well. We actually, for the heat vibration, we didn't take too much into account because there is a, I don't know, it's like a normal foundation, let's say. We didn't care, let's say, too much about it. Maybe we didn't do well, but it was not something that we considered. Does it model with composite earth with effective extraction? Yes, exactly, with effective section or 3D model stream? No, effective section. Yes, the presentation will be provided. I'm not sure about the email, but it will be on the internet to see it. Well, actually, there is one question about the design life of the damper. I cannot say for sure, but I think it's 25 years. But that I have to check. I have to check with the supplier. Is it possible to get reinforcement detail on the bundle of the solid elements? I'm not sure. I don't think so. No, we didn't apply pretension in the cable because they are almost vertical. So mostly we are applying pretension, let's say, during the construction stages, mostly for the cable stay when we are tensioning separately. But here, we just had a structure on the temporary supports, and then removing the supports, and then because of the, let's say, dead loads, the stays will tension tension itself. So it was not really necessary to apply feed tensions. And actually, we checked those stresses on site. I mean, whatever we have in the model, they have been able to check with some kind of checks in the site. Well, there is a question: have you also considered the case in which a hanger breaks? We didn't consider a case when the hanger breaks, but we consider a case when we are changing the hanger, which is more or less the same thing. Yeah, we did, but obviously without the traffic on the bridge. The base thickness of the abutment, I think it's in the presentation also. You can see it here, it's 5.75 meters. And height is around, I don't know, 7 meters in meters. Regarding the question about the damper component generated in CATI and used in MIDAS, I'm not sure. I don't know. When shall we use Metzler and Kempin dampers? Actually, the model which I chose was chosen together with the suppliers, because actually we have to be, let's say, whatever behavior we have in the model, they have to have the same behavior on their model as well. So, together with that, we decided to adopt the Maxwell and Kelvin dampers. The thing is that we have to have this damper should be actually working in two cases. One is like normal service when the objective of the damper is to keep the pitch fixed in the transversal direction, and then a transversal, let's say, instantaneously force which appears like a seismic, damper should act like a damper itself, not like a connector. Normally in the service, like now, it is actually more acting like a connector, not a damper. The damper is only working within the seismic capacity. And I think I also have a former colleague in Parsons. So great. It was, I'm sure that it is a great company. And in Dubai, it was like, for me at least, it was like a golden age. Great. Thank you. Okay, the variation of the results, well, have you compared the MIDAS fair? No, at that time, no. Now we are also using the MIDAS fair, but at that time, no. in 2018 we didn't have access to FEM, but now we have, and we used it, and it's great, really. I mean, MIDAS FEM is really top state of the art, let's say. MIDAS CD is also great, but for something, if you want to go into great details, let's say, into deeper details, FEA it's fantastic, actually. And it's great for modeling, and it's very fast, and it's unbelievable. And then you can design the organization with stress. We didn't have any consideration for impact loads, actually, for the trucks. We have those curbs, which are quite big, so we didn't consider. And actually, it is not possible there to have such big impacts because of the area itself. The bridge is actually at the end of the bridge. There is a roundabout. So you cannot have a very big speed there. It's just limited by the roundabouts. The variation of the results with and without the damper. So the main thing was the fundamental period. Is without the damper, that is 0.7, which is actually matching the corner period of the zone. And with the damper is 2.8. Okay, so thank you very much. I hope that it was, let's say, useful and you enjoyed it, hopefully. And thank you very much. And for any questions, please tell us, and we'll try to provide the information we require. Also, without for the dampers, we, as I told you, tomorrow I'll go to Oradea and I'll go to the bridge and make some pictures, and hopefully it will be on MIDAS site. Thank you very much.